Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of Mechanical Pros. My name is Graham Sosi, and today I'm going to be showing you how to cold roll pipe. So some common applications that we'll see with groove pipe, you'll commonly see with fire sprinkler systems. You'll look up in the air of wherever you're at, you'll see the groove pipe fittings, you'll see Victaulic. But what we commonly use for our trade here with Mechanical Resource Group is we'll groove a pipe to go to our actual piece of gear, whether it be a cooling tower that's already came grooved or a chiller that's came grooved. So this is how we'll start our connection leading into that piece of gear. And we will either continue to groove pipe or we will weld pipe the rest of the way. We're using our Rigid Powerdrive 300. Our attachment we're using is the Rigid 975 combo groover. I've made sure that we are setting level and square with our pipe into our machine here. We're setting in our V-groove stand here. And then I'm also gonna make sure on the other side of this machine that we're set to reverse. Today we're actually going to be grooving 6-inch Schedule 40 carbon steel pipe, which for the Rigid 975 combo groover is the largest material that we can actually groove. There's a couple different things that we need to know about the Rigid 975 groover. We've got a step gauge that tells you what material that you're going to be using, what schedule pipe that you're going to be using, even what size. So as you increase in size, this has incremental steps up the higher size pipe that you go to. You also have an adjustment screw, and then we also have our half-inch drive ratchet that we'll use. So once you verify all that and everything's set up properly, you can then make your first step over here to the 975. And basically what I'm gonna do is, I'm gonna tighten this adjusting nut all the way down until it sets firmly up against the pipe. I will then back off my adjusting screw and adjust over with my step gauge. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. I'm gonna tighten up. And again, I'm just getting it firmly tight up against the pipe. I'm gonna use my step gauge. And I'm gonna take it over here all the way over to 5 and 6 inch Schedule 40 pipe. I will then take my adjusting nut and tighten that all the way up against my step gauge. Once that is firmly tight, I back off of my adjusting nut a 1/4 inch turn, and then I actually rotate this step gauge all the way back to 0. So what that allows me to do is now that as this pipe is getting grooved down, this adjusting screw goes down with it. And once you know that you're complete, this adjusting screw will actually set flush and be extremely tight. So don't over tighten once you feel a good tug and that you can't move it anymore. That's what it's going to be. You're good to go. So now that I've got everything set up, I'm actually going to jog the machine and make sure that my groove does not actually walk away from the pipe. And then once that's started, I'll continue to groove the pipe. And you know, the recommended rotation, you want to see at least 2 to 3 revolutions, so that way you can apply even pressure all the way around the pipe. So we're set up. I'm going to step back to my step pedal here, and I'm going to jog the pipe. It's going to kick a little bit. 6 inch is a seamed pipe, so it's going to have a little bit more rotation, and we're just going to give it a go. Here we go. So I can kind of see after my first initial groove here, there's no walk or any play in the pipe. So now I can really start my rotation. And like I said, we're gonna pick a spot on the pipe, watch it go around 2 to 3 times. And we're gonna tighten 1/4 to 1/2 turn each time. Once that's complete and this adjusting screw has bottomed out, then we'll know we'll have the perfect groove for your pipe. All right, so as I was cranking down, I could feel that this has hit flush down to the bottom of the device here. Now that that's complete, you can loosen up your adjustment groove here, pull your pipe out, refer to your fitting manufacturer's recommendations as far as your measurements concerned for your collar. Now that that's complete, you can go hook up whatever groove fitting that you're needing to go hook up, and that's how you groove pipe. All right, so again, I'm Graham Sosi. Thanks for watching another episode of Mechanical Pros. We have a lot more videos coming. If you have any questions, please leave them down in the comments section below. And also, please remember to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.